Hello, everybody. Welcome to the Stratoscale Hybrid DevOps Pros. I'm Ariel, with Ms. Diaz.
Ariel.
Hi. Today, we're going to talk about deploying three-tier applications. We're going to use Terraform and the EC2 APIs. So, Diaz, what application are we going to deploy?
So, we're going to deploy WordPress. That's a basic
and very popular. I've got five of them at home.
Oh, so now you can run it also. Well, you should. Okay, so we have a three-tier application template, and we're going to run WordPress on that specific template.
Okay, so what are the three tiers that we're looking at?
Okay, so the three apparent tiers are the public facing, we have the load balancer, and what's called the bastion. We're going to discuss it later. We have the private subnet, which hosts everything which is private, web facing, and application.
That's the application tier?
That's exactly. And we have the data tier.
Fantastic. So we're going to use MySQL database, I see.
That's right.
All right. So let's deploy the app.
Let's deploy it. So let's go here.
Okay.
Now I have a folder, and in that folder I have the Terraform, and the Terraform will deploy exactly this. Okay. Let's run it.
Okay.
Okay. And now while this is running, by the way, while it's running, I can go to our beautiful user interface. Right now I'm in the networking overview. And the first VPC that will come up, you'll be able to see that.
Why don't we take a look at the Terraform and see what's being deployed?
Okay, so let's look on how are architected the three-tier application. So if you look at the files, and Terraforms allows us to do a very flexible software architecture of our application.
And so when we're looking at infrastructure as code, we're actually applying software design paradigms to manage our infrastructure.
Exactly. Just like we're doing software, we can divide and conquer. So I have all my networking in that Terraform. So if I click that, you can see that I'm creating AWS VPC.
You're creating a VPC.
Exactly.
You're creating a gateway.
All kinds of subnets. Yes. Okay. Because Terraform allows me to very easily divide everything.
So we describe what we want, and
that's
Terraform
exactly
applies it.
Okay. So that's from the networking section. On the web section, which is the compute.
So our web tier, we're creating some instances.
Exactly. Key pairs, and which we'll be using later. Instances.
And we're applying security groups, I see, on the instances as well for the web server.
Yes.
Okay.
So this is what being applied now. I architected my Terraform. And the whole point, just like you said, since I'm using infrastructure as code, I just need to look at the infrastructure, understand it, and it's very easy to convert that into code. And then, as you can see here, Terraform is doing
all
the rest for us.
Okay, so I see and AWS DB instances, so I'm assuming you're using RDS compatible APIs to deploy a database.
Exactly. Let me show you how easy it is to deploy the database. So database requires its own, in the API, it requires its own subnet, so I created that. Again, just two lines, very easy. Database instance,
yep,
with all the parameters that Terraform allows me to very easily pass to other components of the application, yeah.
So we tell RDS that we want a MySQL database, allocate storage to it, select an engine version.
I don't need to put my mind into anything other than deploy my application, about what storage am I using, engines, and so on. Super easy, and everything goes into the application. And then I can also use specific security groups. That's everything you need to do.
So we're going to use security groups to manage access to all of our different resources.
Yeah, so let's talk now a little bit about the security aspects of the application. So the whole point of three tier is that it's divide and conquer. You're isolating your network, mm-hmm, into all kinds of subnets, and all the dotted lines are actually security groups. So I'm making sure that the load balancer can access
only the web,
the subnet can only be accessed, the database can only be accessed from the webs.
Got it. So what are we using the Bastion server for?
Okay, so let's assume that you want to do some maintenance work on your web-facing instances. First of all, the Bastion allows you to control and audit everything that connects into the web-facing. So if I'm SSHing into the web facing. First, I'm going to SSH into the bastion. I'm using just a simple Ubuntu image. There's many philosophies on how you should harden your bastion. We're not going to go into that. The second purpose of the bastion is to save resources. If I would like to access my web facing instances, I wouldn't have a bastion. I would have to put a public IP on each and every one of them.
I don't want to put a public IP because I want to hide it. Got it.
Yeah. So it serves the two purposes, and it's very easy again to deploy. And
okay, let's take a look.
Right. So right now, you can see that inside my WordPress VPCs, things are already deployed. It will soon refresh. So let's go to an application that I already deployed, okay. And you can see this application actually deployed here. Okay. Every single
component.
So what
are we seeing? I'm seeing a web server subnet, mm-hmm. web server 1 and 0. I'm seeing a database subnet with a WordPress database. I'm seeing my Bastion server mm-hmm. on my public subnet.
Let's go with the tiers. Okay, yeah. So the first tier is the public subnet, which I'm pointing now. And it has the load balancer, and it has the Bastion.
Yep.
Okay. And everything, by the way, is connected to the same default route table. In Symfony, you can do all kind of complex route tables, everything that the VPC APIs allow.
Perfect.
Okay. So this is the public tier. Now, in the web server tier, you can see my web servers. And those web servers actually are connected to my load balancer. Now, if I would like now to scale up the number of web servers, it's a single argument in my Terraform. I can scale 2 to 20, press a button, I'm there. Everything will be connected, load balancers, Bastion,
and if you want to
everything.
Put an auto-scale group on it, then it would even scale
yes.
automatically. That's great.
And the third tier is the database subnet. Again, I'm using only one database subnet, and that's my database instance. And this is the exact replica implementation of that depiction into that. And the only thing I had to do is look on that template and code that into Terraform.
Great.
Very easy.
Let's look at our WordPress.
Yes, let's look at the WordPress. So the only thing I need to do is I'm going to my application. So I asked Terraform to output everything here. So he told me what is the load balancer IP, what's the Bastion IP, and these are the instances. So if I'm going to go to something I already deployed, which is here.
Yep.
Okay. So you can see the load balancer IP is 10.45.30.1.3. So I'm going to that IP over there. That's my WordPress.
Nice.
You can now work here on your WordPress and everything will be
so now I need actually to start a blog.
Yeah, you should.
I have no choice.
So the WordPress is actually working. I don't want to go into that because we don't have enough time, but we can see that everything is
fantastic.
Highly available
and
synchronized.
How do we use the Bastion?
Using the database. And if, for example, you would like to use the Bastion, so what I did here, I SSH'd into the Bastion.
Yeah.
And then from the Bastion into the private IP.
Forwarded to the private IP.
Now I can manage my
web server.
Web server. Just a small thing that should be mentioned. I configured that web server very easily using cloud init. It's super easy to take all the arguments from the different domains of Terraform, put that in single cloud init, web server is up and running.
Fantastic. Great. So now we've seen how we're deploying using Terraform a 3-tier web app on Symfony. Thanks, Jazz.
Thank you, Ariel.